And joining us on the record today is a congressional candidate today for the Libertarian Party. U.S. Congressional District 4 nominee is Gregory Maxwell. Sir, thank you so much for joining us today.
I'm glad to be here.
And we're going to go straight into the issues. Let's talk about the hot topic, abortion. After the U.S. Supreme Court overturned the Roe v. Wade decision, lots of states, including Arkansas, had some trigger laws. Some people are calling for federal exemptions to those very strict anti-abortion laws like we have in Arkansas. So should the federal government get involved? What is the federal government's role in this when it comes to abortion?
Well, it's a good question, and everybody needs would like a good answer. The right answer, but right now it's you had 50 years of Roe versus Wade.
Right.
You had 50 years of protecting the abortion rights. They're dropping it to the states. I understand that, and that's, you know, acceptable. Maybe state, but the states weren't prepared. Mm-hmm. They didn't. They should have given a heads up, because it does take two people to make an abortion. Mm-hmm. Men should shelter some of the responsibility, and it's not just a women's thing. But the women out have the ultimate choice. But if they don't have a place to go and they're stuck, how do they get to where they need to go? Because time is critical. It's all about timing. Mm-hmm. I mean, from 6 weeks, from conception to 6 weeks to 20 weeks. So we need to fix some type of a net for them.
Do you think there should be some federal exemptions to abortion?
Exemption.
Like in Arkansas right now, the only way you can have an abortion if it affects the life of a mother for medical emergencies. So no rape, no incest. Should the federal government get involved and say, if you were raped or if you're a victim of incest, then abortion is okay?
Absolutely. I mean, if my body was violated as Greg Maxwell and then I had to carry some strangers, I mean, there should be it should be at least a federal tattoo on it, you know, to tack on it. So, I mean, it's important.
The national debt just climbing, ticking up every single day, $31 trillion plus at the moment. What to you is the government wasteful spending?
Well, wasteful spending? $31 trillion, I mean, it's hot topic. It's burning our finances. $31 trillion, it's hard to imagine that number, less alone in dollars, in minutes, but yet the government spends it at such an amount of rate. I don't know, we've got to find a reset clock and start all over with it, because that is a massive amount to overcome, repay. Mm. I don't have those numbers, but once you're inside the, I guess, the government club, okay, right now there's a red club and a blue club. Mm. We're the gold club, the libertarian, and people need to take advantage of that, because they have an inside of lots of other ideas that have been kept out by the mainstream media.
Do you see any programs or agencies that you think is wasteful spending that you think that we can cut from?
Wasteful spending. A lot of people say the liberal arts, but art brings creativity. There are some entitlement options that need to be reworked and revamped, because people take advantage of it when they find the loophole to take advantage of it. As an example, all the you're seeing now people being prosecuted because they took advantage of the Pandemic Care Act, because they just made up businesses and added personnel and collected money on that, and now they're getting caught. But was loopholes like that need to be shut?
How do we fix the inflation as is right now? What does the federal government need to do to help with the dramatically increasing costs?
The inflation, I know, I get almost sick in my stomach and depressed every time, because everything I buy is 20-30% more every time I go. How they get the number of 10%, I don't know. I don't know. Because it's 10% per month, when you add a dollar to a dollar, mm-hmm. that's 100% interest or inflation on a product. And you bought products, and why is it twice the price? And this happened since the election, the inception of the new president, if you track back the records. And it stopped, and it's dropped a lot of morale. Mm-hmm. We need a morale builder. If we can cut inflation, we can do that. And I didn't get to buy the $2 gas prices. I was in Russellville. We didn't have $2 gas prices.
Mm-hmm. So how does the federal government fix that immediately?
Immediately. Well, he's supposed to open if he hadn't shut down the pipeline, we might be going. Mm-hmm. Okay. If we hadn't shut down the pipeline, we might still be rolling comfortably, mm-hmm. but it's too much anxiety for everybody, mm-hmm. which creates division because my side is right, your side is wrong, but you have the third party now, mm-hmm. the Libertarians, where we can meet in the middle.
All right, Gregory Maxwell, thank you so much. Libertarian Party candidate for U.S. Congressional District 4.